He didn't look anything like the other ducklings, and he didn't say much, just a puny little quack that you could hardly hear.
What if it is a turkey poult? What do I do with it then?
Said the mother duck anxiously. Then you get to give him to his turkey mum, or he can fly to her himself, quacked the ducklings, trying out their own little wings. The mother duck decided to let the duckling come to the pond with the others, because clearly, if he could swim, he wasn't a turkey. All the ducklings splashed in and swam in a tiny line behind the mother duck. The big duckling was right at the back, paddling with his duck feet.
Thank goodness it didn't turn out to be a turkey. It's definitely a duckling of mine, sighed the mother duck.
All the ducks swam around the pond for a while. The water was warm, and they competed as to who could dive the fastest down to the bottom and then come back up to the surface.
Come now, children. Let's go into the barn and say hello to the other animals.
The ducklings climbed out of the pond and lined up obediently in a row behind their mum, while the big duckling brought up the rear as usual. The mother duck pushed the door open and showed the ducklings into the barn, which was full of other ducks and hens and roosters and pigs and sheep and cows and a horse.
Hello, all you animals. I brought my latest ducklings for you to look at. Aren't they sweet?
They are, came the reply from all the animals. And there was a tremendous clucking and bleating and mooing. Suddenly, there was silence. Nobody said anything for a long while.
But who's that there?
Clucked a hen finally.
Yes, what kind of funny-looking duckling is that?
Neighed the horse.
Is it a boy?
Asked a rooster.
Yes, he's my son. Isn't he a fine-looking boy? Said the mother duck.
That's the ugliest duck I've ever seen,
crowed the rooster.
Yes, he looks awful. A real freak of nature,
oinked the pig.